Hey Raiders, Mr. Engel here. Just a couple of quick reminders of things upcoming in the next week and some important documents that I need you to fill out. Quick reminder, remember next week, January 25th through the 29th, is the last week of the first semester. The second semester will begin February 2nd. Remember, February 1st, Monday, is a teacher work day, so no students on that day. But February 2nd is the first day of the second semester. So last week, get all your work turned in. Make sure your attendance is where it needs to be. Do what you need to do to show your teachers you care and you want to make the best grade possible. With that in mind, I want to remind everyone that the hybrid schedule is going to stay in place. We've been fortunate enough to work with such a great school board and school district leadership that they recognize that COVID numbers are continuing to rise and that we want to make sure that our number one priority is always yours and your family's safety. So we are going to keep the hybrid option in place. So if you want to stay on the hybrid, great. You have to do nothing. Southwest Raider, just continue as is. However, if you want to switch to 5 days a week, we do have a form that we need you to just fill out. It's a petition to be 5 days a week. Please fill it out. I know that many of you have indicated earlier you would like to. I know it's another form and I'm sorry, but please do fill it out so that we can make sure that if you want to be here 5 days a week, we got you. Okay, so we're going to work with you to make that happen. Next thing I want to talk about is, hey, in the first semester, we know there's been a ton of things going on from internet to COVID to family members to, you know, some of you've had to take on an extra job and or take care of siblings. Please make sure you fill out your attendance petition waiver. It's very critical that as we move forward, you remember you can only have 5 absences in any class. And more than that means you lose credit even if you pass the class. So make sure you fill out your attendance waiver. Make sure you're doing your part to keep us informed. The number one thing for us to help you is we got to know about the issues that you face this first semester. Again, our PSAT for sophomores is on January 26. If you're an 11th grader who missed it in the fall, you also can take it. There is a form to fill out, and we'll put this link on here to reserve your spot, get your ticket. For the PSAT, we want you to make sure you reserve your spot so that we can make sure that we have people put in the right place. We don't have too many people in one spot, so we can keep everyone socially distanced and make sure that we're doing all we can to follow those guidelines. And talking about grades, we're going to present a link in here that you can practice doing your first 6 weeks, second 6 weeks, and third 6 weeks grade calculation. You can play and make sure you find your average. You can also look at the number of absences you need. So it's a good tool to kind of help you get focused and make sure you have calculated the right grade you need this third 6 weeks in order to receive credit. Remember, the way you receive credit for the first semester is you take your first, second, third 6 weeks, you add up all your numbers, and then you divide by 3. That's going to give you your average. Once you get your average for the first, second, and third 6 weeks, that's going to be your grade for the first semester. You also have to have a attendance requirement, and I believe I've already told you that you can have no more than 5 absences. We also, parents, we really, you know, it's that time of year where we're starting to buy new things, get things moving, and we want to do a lot of support, and certainly for our seniors who are graduating. It's been unique. Our PTA usually gets together, and this year we haven't been able to, but we really do need parents who support us and continue to help drive things and make sure that our kids are, you know, get the best representation from both the school and the community. So please consider joining the PTA. Your partnership is so appreciated. So there's a link to that. And finally, this month is our school board appreciation. Ms. Darr, our school board representative here at Southwest High School, she's active, she's positive, she cares about the kids, she cares about your views. And we're just very lucky to have such a wonderful school board member. So I want to take a moment to say thank you to her and all that she's done to help make Southwest be such an incredible place to learn at, work at, and just to enjoy every day. Till next time, Raiders, I appreciate you. I miss you. You got this. Go Raiders.